Spider. He shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. Psalm 91, verse 4 to 6. People are unnecessarily scared by many things. One of the most common phobias is the fear of spiders. A phobia is an unnatural fear. Almost 50% of women and 10% of men fear spiders. The fear of spiders is called arachnophobia. Spiders can be the most creepy bugs. However, they can also be most fascinating. Spiders and scorpions are not insects because they have 8 legs and not 6. They are called arachnids. Most kinds of spiders are predators and eat other insects. They don't have antennae like other insects. They do, however, have large fangs and can inject venom. A spider's mouth isn't large enough to eat solid foods. Thus, it first breaks down the food and liquefies the prey with enzymes before ingesting. Spiders can see very well. They have 4 sets of eyes, 8 eyes in total, of which the front 2 is used to discern shape and movement, and the rest are used to distinguish between light and dark. The male spider is smaller than the female and sometimes get eaten after the mating process. The female lays hundreds upon thousands of silky eggs in a cocoon. The larvae also stay in the cocoon until they are ready to emerge as tiny spiders. Most female spiders look well after their young. She provides food for the young and sometimes carry them around on her body. Every spider needs to shed its skin a couple of times since the skin is not pliable. Some species of spiders have hairs and other scary-looking sharp spines on their bodies. It uses these to smell and feel vibrations. The body consists of 2 main parts: the head or upper body, cephalothorax, and the lower body, the abdomen. Inside the hard exterior of the exoskeleton, the spider has muscles which help the legs to bend. These legs also work hydraulically when it wants to extend its legs or if it wants to move forward. This is the reason why a dead spider's legs are always curled up. There are about 4,000 different kinds of spiders. They have different shapes, sizes, and colors. Only a few kinds are dangerous to humans, as they only bite people to protect themselves. The dangerous kinds include the black widow, recluse spider, and button spider. Button spiders and black widows are distinguished from the rest of the spiders by a distinctive red hourglass shape on the stomach. Although daddy long legs are extremely poisonous, they do not have the ability to bite people because their jaws are too small. Spiders can be useful when getting rid of other insects like mosquitoes. Some have venom or poison that are used in insecticide. Most spiders only live about 2 years. The only exception to that rule would be the tarantula. Tarantulas are large spiders which can be kept as pets. They can live up to 20 years or more. In countries like Venezuela and Cambodia, they are dried, cooked, or even fried as a special treat. Spiders have different ways of catching their prey. Some can camouflage, act as if it is an insect, or can catch other insects with a long, sticky rope of silk. They can chase insects or jump on them and bite them. Some spiders, however, spin a web. The web traps insects when they fly into it. The diversity of the spider species makes them so fascinating. Under the spider's abdomen, there are many openings or spinnerets which are connected to different silk production glands. The silk produced by spiders is so strong, the entire body of the spider can be supported by one strand of silk. It is also so sticky that insects stuck in the web will not easily be set free. Like the spider, the devil has many ways of catching, attacking, or cheating his prey. Through the ages, he has tried to spin his web of lies to get people to fall under his control. In Genesis 3, he approached the very first woman, Eve, and planted doubt in her heart. He asked her, "Has God indeed said, 'You shall not eat of every tree of the garden?'" And the woman said to the serpent, "We may eat the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the middle of the garden, God has said, 'You shall not eat it, nor shall you touch it, lest you die.'" Then the serpent said to the woman, "You will not surely die, for God knows that in the day you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree desirable to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate, and also gave to her husband with her, and he ate. Eve thought the fruit would give them the same knowledge God has, and fell right into the devil's trap. It made them feel scared, guilty, and ashamed, and robbed them of their former glory. Many people to this day get caught in webs of addiction, violence, hatred, or fear. They do not realize the enemy wants to catch them in his web of lies, where he can slowly suck the life from them. Paul warns us to be wary of spider webs. In 2 Timothy 2 verse 26, he prays that people may come to their senses and escape the snare of the devil, having been taken captive by him to do his will. The good news is, Jesus came to set us free from evil. For John 8 verse 36 promises, "If the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed."